Alright, welcome back everyone. So I just unlocked Pendles here and I'm about to go play some matches with him, but although we went and saw him on the wiki, just a quick overview. We have Corner Sneak that is his passive that activates when he's out of line of sight of enemies, and he gets a movement speed increase while cloaked, but decreases when uncloaked. And I've heard he's kind of slow like Alani when she first came out while uncloaked, so we'll see how I like that. Then he's got his dual Kamaz and throwing stars. Melee attack with a ranged one, which is very cool. I like the look of his weapons here. Snakeborn, negative 25% CC duration for a talent, which is a cool one because I hate CC. And that's not only like your stuns and your locks, but it's also like slows and all that stuff. So really comes in handy. Then we have Smoke Bomb, where he throws a smoke bomb at his feet, dealing some damage and some dot damage, and it instantly cloaks him. We have Injection, which gives him 200 damage on an enemy, heavily slowing them for 2 seconds. And his ultimate covers himself in an airborne poison that does 240 damage over 10 seconds. And while that's active, his injection is on a cooldown. I'm assuming he's got pretty quick cooldowns in at least these two, but we will see. On his Helix here, I'm not going to go through all these, so I'm going to do those in the match. On his appearance, let's just look at his skins and taunts quick. So this is his regular one. Nothing too great so far. And this is his tier 2. I don't know if that's really all that cool. Well, it gives him kind of a cybernetic look. Can we spin around here, take a peek? The angle's kind of bad at this. It's kind of hard to see him. Let's see.
Show him my best today.
I like the accent. Okay, that's pretty fucking funny. And then his lore and stats, which I have none of. So I'll be right back and be in a match. Alright, so here I am, and cool, I start off cloaked. I am going to just run through all the missions with him, starting with normal and then do them all in advanced. I'm kind of planning on doing this with all the new characters as a way to kind of get myself playing them, and just figured why not do that as a series. So this first one, I don't know. I'm gonna try the duration. I went with my melee DPS loadout that I use for Atticus to increase health. All right, so when I attack, and then I come auto cloak, and then I come in cloak. All right, so this is kind
of
cool. So you have to press that for every time you want to use it. Oh no, it does keep throwing. It's got some pretty heavy drop-off. But it's going to leave that there for them. Alright, decent AoE size on that. Use that just to get a cloak. I do like the way this cloaking mechanism works. Okay, that was kind of nice. And try to drag some people into that, but they're not going to go for it.
Best watch your back next time.
He is a bit on the slow side. Well, that was a leg spike. Blind. I'll use the throw. I don't think I really need the blind in this. And the throw, I can kind of hit some enemies where I want them to go. Go back for this guy.
Ooh. Bad news, friend. Your enemies are me first.
Okay, so now I've just got that guy, and I'll activate my gear. Really?
Don't worry! His lethal neurotoxin's 100%
organic. Where the fuck did he... There he is. Alright. This map kind of sucks for melee characters, but whatever. We'll see. So, I'll start off with my attack speed. Then I'm pretty soon I can get some lifesteal. Actually, I'll go up there and get that stuff. If I can jump. Or I'll just go through the door here. I never knew there was a door there. I've always just jumped across there. That's real clever and all, you know? Hey, Helix. Cool. Yeah, I'll take the lifesteal. I definitely think that's a little bit better.
That jawbone will make a lovely door knocker. Someone grab it!
Where'd that Ronin go? Ah, oh, there you are. So yeah, his cooldowns are fairly fast here. God, it's really easy to cloak with him. I can see that backstab bonus would be huge on him though, because 25% a lot, and it's really easy to get him.
That's been hatched. Why, yes, it certainly does.
It's the lasers. The lasers are what do it. They draw the eye.
Yeah, it's almost like they're... Sorry, this is gonna sound dumb.
To you? I was just
use
going
that
to
just
say
to get
that.
A dot yeah, teleporter and kill that faster.
What? There are lasers going on right now?
Nice.
It's a laser defense grid, Mel.
Yeah, vent hatches. What did she say?
Oh, why did I go for skill damage there? I meant to do the other one. I'll get it fast enough here. I have a cheap loadout. I think a white and two greens. You guys could probably hear the dog drinking water in the background. My roommate's got a dog, and holy crap, he's loud when he eats. He just slops through that water like there's no tomorrow. Definitely use that on him. Don't want to screw around with these Rocketeer bots. They are the bane of my existence. Alright, so lifesteal or additional poison. See, it's only lifesteal in that one attack, but if I put dots on it, it'll give me more lifesteal. I'm going to go with the additional dot on it. Not too worried. This is just normal mode, so...
Welcome to Fort Akaban, interloper. I'm Isaac, a crazy computer dude, and these are my friends. They're robots, and they're
dude,
really
I'm loving
deep.
This stealth, especially on this map. Which is typically pretty bad for melee characters, but he can just sneak up here and use it. It's pretty awesome.
This whole ambush thing isn't going as well as I'd hoped. Better reinforce those forces.
It'll help him also for reviving people. Yeah, you get in close with that. Yeah. So far, kind of liking him. We'll see how he measures up, though, at the end of the day. What loadouts are good for him, what's his damage like. He does seem a little pillow-fisted here. In normal mode, I should be able to take out those
found my mark that time, didn't
some of these things a little bit faster, so his melee doesn't seem that powerful, and that can be bad. And his attack speed isn't that great either, so... we'll see how all that works out with him. That would be my one worry, is he's a bit on the weak side there. Alright, so it's just him. Should probably get another drone here. I can run around here and just cloak. I'll get an assault drone. Let him hit it. Actually, I was able to deal with him pretty effectively. Between the cloak. I like throwing the bombs, then getting my cloak back, and then hitting him with the spike. But I can see where the dash would come in useful on that. So I think next match I do, I might try that dash. Oh, they saw me. The cooldown gear on him would be pretty damn strong. Nice. Legendary. Do that same thing. Do that. Get behind. Ah, he knocked me down. What a prick. Yeah, just the ability to run around without getting constantly shot at by these guys makes this kind of interesting. Not quite used to that. Nice, rare gear too. You know, before I move... oh wait, I can get bots right at the bottom of here. So yeah, movement speed might be a thing with him. Should have looked at my experience first. I might have been able to kill those guys before I did that. I'm going to go with the cooldown on that, because I'm not worried about taking damage while cloaked. Alright, let's try this out on these guys. Interesting. I didn't know he cloaked while he does that. Very cool. Well, I guess I would have been cloaked because they didn't see me. But I stayed cloaked after I put off the skill. Don't really need all of that, but I took it. So that seems fairly effective, especially within his range and stuff. You add that to everything else he's doing, and his ability to sneak up. Throw a blind bomb, hit that, and just all the win.
We can't disable that checkpoint remotely. Destroy the shard's power.
I'm gonna go up and deal with these snipers because these guys are dickheads. And that should get a Ronin here. Oh crap. That was a lot of damage I just took. Oh no, boombot. Do not like them.
Ah! Serving up my speciality.
Yeah, this isn't good. I need health. Health. Alright.
Lovely work right there. I'm rather pleased.
His lifesteal seems pretty strong. And the fact that I can just kind of stand up here, not take damage because people don't see me is really fucking good. Let's even get some health before I go back and attack him. Got my ulti, I'm going to quick kill that station too so no one spawns on my back. And then I'll go deal with that guy. Hide. Stealth. There we go. So maybe we can see how lifesteal on that thing would be good. But anything that can boost his lifesteal is going to make him really, I think, pretty strong. Get his survivability up there, because that looks a bit on the weak side. But I can see how he's going to be a pain in PvP. With some good players, figure him out.
Minimum lethal foe supply.
God, I hate Rocketeer bots.
Oh, just observe the craftsmanship of that kill. Beautiful.
Guys.
If you want a piece of this, Magnus, you'll have to get through Jeff, my most violent S1 Sentry.
Just grab this stuff over here.
But crazy lethal. Say, Jeff,
you never know when you're going to get a Helix.
Love you to kill, and I'd like...
I'm Arachnus, the Spider King, Lord of all spiders.
Definitely don't need shards.
Okay. You're not a spider.
Should get a more expensive loadout. This is a little too cheap.
Jeff.
I love Jeff. Oh god, this part would be so easy with him,
Really committed to this whole
the fact I can just cloak and stand on those points. This part is terrible pacing. It drives me nuts.
Facilities equipped with fumigators to deal with the constant outbreaks of bliss bugs, the nasty little bastards. Give Jeff a lungful. Perhaps that'll shake him loose.
Alright. Next one, injections damage from behind 25%. That I'm going to definitely go with. That's easy to get with him.
Ah, poison gas. Lethal to giant spiders. I better kill these clowns.
Yeah, I wish his ranged attack had a little bit more oomph to it. Just kind of seems a bit pointless at this point. Maybe I'm just not used to it.
Now. Oh, Spider King has got you.
Nice. See if it works on him.
You'll get a broodling.
I hate when he kind of moves like that where you can't hit him.
Jeff, I've had just about enough of your bullshit.
Pick up my yellow balls.
Don't upgrade your abilities at one of those service stations.
Now this will be a joke, because guys won't be able to hit me.
Jeff out of that structure.
I can just walk around and ignore them all.
Go activate the building's fumigation systems. Let's see how
this is kind of funny. Wait, did I finish? I always do that. Does he see me? Or is he shooting at my drone? Nope, shooting at my drone. Well, this is the easiest these have ever been. I mean, I don't mess with those guys.
Back outside.
Dad, this gas business is becoming
didn't see that coming. Oh no, he killed my drone.
Got all 8 eyes on you. Spiders have a lot of eyes, get it? Firmware downloads complete.
This spider's got brand new fangs.
Cool. Now do something violent with them, or I'll send you screaming into Minrek's gaping maw.
I am not a robot. I am a spider.
Did that miss him? Come on, 25% less CC duration work. And get the yellow balls.
Do it again.
All right, so I'm starting to kind of get into this guy a little bit. Wait, did I just go in the wrong one? I did. Silly me. I thought that door closed after you were done with it. Apparently not. Once again, they're just going to shoot at my drone. I would attack him there. He'd be so easy to kill, but I just really don't need to. I feel like such a badass just walking through all these guys. Oh, nice. I can even open those things without unstealthing. This is freaking cool. Height of jump. I'm gonna try the extra throwing star since I'm disappointed with his melee or his range.
Fumigators online.
That should make a big difference to it, obviously. Alright, so I'm just gonna walk out of here and ignore them because
well,
I can.
Jeff, this is your last shot. Either you kill them, or they kill you, or I kill you. I'll probably kill you, but be sure to kill them first.
Beautiful strike on that sentry!
Spider!
And fight over.
Another ex-genius on the slab!
And legendary drops are still increased. Don't know how long they're keeping that for. Seems like they just keep extending it. But I'm all for it. Did it list which one? I probably already have it. Firmware update, yeah. Even got to sneak up on that guy. Should have got new drone while I was there. It's the last time I can spend shards, but whatever. That bomb seems to be doing... I know that's only small enemies in normal. Alright, 10 striker bots.
Found my mark that time, didn't I?
Six. Oh shit, I'm getting a little bit low here. And there's 10. Are there any left? Take them out before I, what was hurting me there?
Those vent shafts will open if the ambient temperature rises too high. Shut down those coolers and let's turn up the heat, eh?
Throw still seems kind of crappy. But that doesn't.
Something foul in the air, mates.
And he's about to blow. Oh crap. Oh, is he in my dot? Or did I not make it there? I think I went down. Damn. He was low enough on health. I would have thrown my bomb a little bit further. I would have killed him.
I've still got contracts to fulfill.
Alright. Let's go get revenge on these fuckers. Oh, I never killed that one.
Wait, I got it. We hit him with a logical paradox.
Captain, that won't work.
Hey, Isaac.
Hey, Captain Galt.
This statement, it's a lie. Bam! Cyber headshot.
Oh no, my brain! My brain is...
Alright, so he can put out some pretty good damage pretty quick. Of course, I was using all three skills, getting my ulti out.
Oh, great!
Your mushy brain will forget your mother's face before it forgets LL.
Well, those guys have some decent health. Jingles. Which one did I miss? There we go.
Oh, man.
What did I tell you?
Yeah, I really don't like his ranged attack. Nowhere near as cool as Deonde's fan or Shane Norok's boomerang.
I told you.
That was a free sample. Here, take my business card.
Get some swarmer kills there. I'm sure there's some kind of lore challenge for him with that.
This'll get your blood pumping. All congealing, not exactly sure.
Core temperature rising. Excellent. The vents are open. Quickly now. Activate that drill. We must hurry to the Magnus.
So yeah, my worry about him feeling OP is not needed. He doesn't feel bad or anything, but definitely doesn't feel OP. Smoke bombs, cooling time or damage? I'll probably go cooldown on there. Of course, I already have that other cooldown one, but yeah, it seems like throwing that a lot and getting that dot out is probably a good thing. Yeah, it's that dead thing that I just absolutely obliterated. Eh, I'll pick up these. I'm not worried about those guys spawning. Go for score, right?
Oh, just observe the craftsmanship of that.
Never tried his quick melee yet. That's kind of a cool animation. Got some range to it too. You're gonna do your disappearing thing. Yep.
The blasted thing is regenerating. Quickly, kill its underlings before it resurfaces.
I'll save my ulti for when he comes back.
That one's going on my back.
Fucker threw me away. Alright, not bad.
Quite right, I'm on a roll today.
Yeah, no legendary from him. Only two so far. What a bunch of shit, right? Yeah, cooldown to get that off more often. And what's next? Yeah. I think I'm going to go with the ejection cooldown, too, and just be able to spam those things. That sounds like a better idea to me.
Runtime on the algorithm is, I like that with Alani. 82% completed. Just a few percents to go, and we'll be,
come on, Helix.
We call existence.
That's the thing that sucks about this level. You don't always get up to level 10 by the end of it. I wish they would fix that. Give us more enemies or something. You have enough bosses in this too, or just the boss experience probably. You kind of have those two mini bosses, then you have Jeff, then you have that golem you just fought, and it's kind of a shame to get through all that and not get to level 10.
Hope you still got some fighting you after that.
Kill five guardians.
Finish what the LLC could not. Destroy that bastard Magnus.
I want to get to those fucking guys, but I want to get my challenge. Alright, now I'll do these guys. Really? Dickhead.
Lovely work right there. I'm
oh, that's fun. Oh shit. Did not want to step in fire. And more of those stupid snipers. So overkill for that guy. There he is. Ooh. Do a little sneaky on the Ronin here. That's nice. I know it's not a, like, advanced 5 player or anything, but it still feels good to kill a Ronin that quick. Keep underestimating the distance of that thing. It looks like it's going to go further. I like the little stealth icon too next to my next to my skills there, when you're in stealth or not. Just a cool animation. I'm gonna quick run down here, see if I get a helix. So like I said, I hate the fact that you don't get to the max level. And at 5 player, it's kind of at the point you just get there, or like right before or at the end boss a lot of times, but yeah, you should get there more reliably. Only level 8's kind of disappointing. So this will be interesting, because melee characters aren't that great at this boss fight. I had one death that was kind of sloppy on my part. I should have avoided that. I came damn close if I was throwing the smoke bomb further or sooner and gone stealth. But it's going to be interesting again to see how this guy holds up in multiplayer. Well, at least I can throw things at him. Which means I probably made the right choice of picking the extra throwing stars. That'll come in handy.
You're on your way to an inky infinite abyss. Have a great trip!
Alright, one out. Got some good damage on that. It would have been nice if I had my ultimate for it, but I wasted it on one of his legs. I don't like getting stuck under him. Yeah, you can't even see me. Where'd he go? Is he in the wall? God damn it, Isaac.
Bad news, friend.
What's going on?
Say, since you came all this way, why not help me test some of the way cool robots I'm designing by throwing yourself before them and letting them kill you effortlessly? Doesn't that sound like fun? Yes, yes, it does sound like fun.
Alright, Isaac, stop being a dick and let me take off your legs. This time I'm saving my ultimate, though.
They dead yet? Nope, I suppose not. Oh well, more minions.
Chasing the leg. Maybe not. Maybe if I kill enough of those guys, I'll level up here.
That one's going on my best of reel!
God damn it. Terrible timing.
Venom applied.
Sometimes I hate this boss. Oh, you dickhead. That leg is so weak, just let it die. There we go. Nice, two-facing him, though. So yeah, when I can hit him, I put out the damage. Just doesn't feel like he's doing all that much damage, but he is. What? That wasn't enough? He looks like he's totally in range. Eh, that's a bunch of crap. Biden said that's malarkey. Hit that entirely too late. Wait, that does him in? Fucking retarded. Well, those are doing some pretty decent damage to him, too.
Let's do this some other
smoke time. Bomb! I hit him with it. Nice. Like the little sound effects of them hitting. It reminds me of like an 8-bit Nintendo game. Yeah, get close. There we go. Wasn't too bad, actually. His first stage was more annoying.
You got him! You captured Isaac!
A legendary. And now I get my level up. Of course. So anyways, that's my first little look at him here. Yeah, seems pretty interesting now. I definitely think I'd go with a movement speed bonus with him, so I'll build a loadout for him now that I've done one match with him. I've got a purple that's both sprint and movement, so you can take advantage of getting backstrike on people better. And I think that's going to be a pretty good setup for him. So let's see what I unlock here. Come on, game. Okay. Silver. I misskipped a lot. Alright, Henchman's Capacitor. I think I had that already. Unlock the title. Only got to level 2, not to 3. It's not double XP or anything. So that's not bad. You know, as long as I'm here. Alright, so times recloaked 198. Enemy slowed for 73 seconds. Melee damage dealt from behind. Haha. Alright, come on. Gear. I'm going to quick see what new I got. I think I already had firmware updates, I'm pretty sure. Cooldown and sprint speed. Wouldn't be bad for him. No. Alright, let's quick look at him, and then I'll build a loadout for him quick. Alright, Pendles. Let's see our lore now that I've done a match. Kill 20 Battleborn while your ultimate is active. That shouldn't be too bad. Hitman for hire. Use 100 smoke bomb 100 times while under CC. That'll happen fairly quickly in PvP, I'd imagine. 500 damage after uncloaking 100 times. If I did that 52 times already, that's going to be easy. 50,000 damage to enemies from behind. I only did 5,000. That's a little disappointing. But I'll make better use of that later. That won't take too long. I mean, at this rate, 10 matches. And tentacle slap enemy Battleborns 50 times. I don't know how I got that once. Alright, so let's build a Pendles loadout. I think I was playing with some here, but I didn't really like this, actually. CC. Alright, so first thing I'm going to do is movement speed. Oh, I got a pack, too. I'm going to open that quick. Oh, and I can buy packs. I'm going to buy some rogue packs quick, too. Alright, you. Aw, they're back to regular price. Shame. Okay. Back to my loadout, though. So I definitely want movement speed with him, and I've got some purple boots. Where are they? Movement and sprint. Is that max? It is. No. Alright, so movement and sprint for sure. I'm definitely going to go with my attack damage and attack speed gloves. And what else do I want with him? No, that wouldn't be that good. That's not bad, but I don't know how often. If I'm going to go attack speed, I just go white there. I already got a fist. I already got movement speed. Doesn't need reload. I don't think I need any health with him right now, at least. I might just go back to my white attack speed. Is there any legendaries that would be badass with him? And I'm doing some story mode first, so I don't need that. No. I think I'm just going to go with attack speed with him for now. Because that will help his survival. So just a basic white attack speed. So now I got movement speed, attack damage, twice attack speed, and sprint speed to kind of get where I want with him. I'm happy with that for now. We'll keep playing around with it and see what I like. But that's my first take on Pendles. I'm going to run through all the maps on him on both modes. And also I'll be doing some PvP with him. So thanks for watching. Bye.